हाय, आई एम डॉक्टर श्याम कुमार बी पाटिल, प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, साई विद्या इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, बैंगलोर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर लेक्चर ऑन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डिटर्मिनिस्टिक फाइनाइट ऑटोमेटा टू रिकॉग्नाइज द स्ट्रिंग। For example, you can take any string like a shine and hire. Before constructing finite automata for this two string, these two strings shine and hire, we need to find out the alphabet used in order to construct the shine and hire. The design DFA should accept all the strings ending with either shine or hire. And any string is made up of the symbols either S, H, I, N, E, R. You can see this finite automata which accept all the strings made up of symbols S, H, I, N, E, R and ending with either shine or hire. Okay, so you can see this is the final figure. So I'll show you how to construct this complex deterministic finite automata which accept all the strings made up of symbol shine ER and ending with the string shine and hire. First, what you can do, construct the NFA for the shine and hire. So, by keeping the common input and two different outputs. So, this is the NFA for the shine, SHINE, and this is HIRA. Then, slowly convert all these NFA state into the DFA state. So, sigma is, it is a SHINER. This is the sigma. Totally, you can find here six symbols are there in the sigma. From initial state, I need to mark four more outgoing transition. And in the problem, condition is given, it is a AND. Hence, the remaining four outgoing transition from the initial state, you can make it as a loop. See, INERSH. Okay, so the first state is converted into DFA state. Like that, see, from this already H is there, five more outgoing transition I need to mark from the state number two. From this arrow mark, I come to know that this is the termination point for the symbol S. So from this arrow mark, I come to know that this is the termination point for the symbol H. Okay. So from this S, I need to mark. H is already there. I need to mark S. So this is the acceptor for the S. You can make S as a loop. S as a loop and H is this four more outgoing transition. So four more outgoing transition. This is the state which accept INER. Hence, from the state number two on the symbol INER, it is to the state number one. So like that, you need to mark the outgoing transition from three, like that, from seven. From three, Already one is there, five more outgoing transition I need to mark. Yes is to the this state number 2, because from this I come to know that this is the termination point for the yes. So for yes, 3 on yes to the 2, then 3 on any R to the state number 1, 3 on H to the state number 7. Like this, you can complete from the state number 8. So from the state number 8, S to the this, H to the this, I N E to the state number 1. From the 4, so S is to the this, I E to the this, H is to the this, and R to the state number 9 and N to the state number 5. So like this, you can complete 6 outgoing transition from the each state. From the 5, you can find 6 outgoing transition. From the 6, you can find from the 6, you can find 6 outgoing transition. Even from the 10 also, you can find 6 outgoing transition. This is the one, second one, and plus 4 symbol to the state number 1. So after combining all these states, this is how the figure looks. Okay, so the state number, this 2 has a relation with the 1, that's what it is at all. So state number even 3 has a relation with the 1, so it is a 13. And the substring from the initial state SH, it is taking to the substring H and I, this is H and I, the substring of the SH I is H and I. From the initial state H and I to the state number 8, that is what it is, a 148. So like that you can take the SH. So substring is a H. From the initial state on H to the 7, hence it is a 137. Like that you can name the states. So it has a relation with the 1, that's what it is, a 15. It has a relation with the 1, that's what it is, a 16. This is the final figure which going to accept or which is going to recognize all the strings made up of the symbol SH, I, N, E, R, and ending with the either string SH, I, N, E, R, H, I, R, E. For example, if you want to search the strings web and DB, before designing the finite automata which is going to search the strings web and DB, you need to find out what are the symbols are used in order to construct the two strings called as a web and EB. So totally 5 symbols are used in order to construct the two string called as a web and EB. Same concept. So what you can do, keeping initial state as a common, construct the NFA for the string WEB and NFA for the EB. So NFA for the WEB, NFA for the EB. And from this state number 1, I need to mark 3 more outgoing transition, because it recognizes the strings ending with the either web or AB. End is there, that's what the remaining outgoing transition from initial state is, a loop to the initial state. So next, state number 2, you can convert into the DFA states. From this, this is the acceptor for the W. W I need to mark from the state number 2, so definitely it will become loop. From this arrow mark, I come to know that state number 1 is acceptor for the BAY. So from here also BAY to the state number 1. Even you can find BAY. B is already there. So that's what only A and Y. A and Y. So from the state number 3, W is to the this, AY to the this, E to the this, because already B is there, 1, 2, 3, 4, then 5. So from each state, 5 outgoing transitions, such a machine is called as the deterministic finite automata. From 6 also you can find W is to the state number 2, B and Y to the state number 1, E to the state number 5, and A is already there. It is state number 7. This is how you can complete all the non-deterministic finite state into the deterministic finite state. From the final state 4, W to the this, because already this state has been made, except for the W, from any of the state W comes, you can terminate to the state number 2. So like that, BAY, all BAY is terminated to the state number 1. E is terminated to the state number 5. So this is from the 8. And this one is the final figure. See, you can mark this state, it was 2, now it has a relation with the initial state, that's what 1, 2, it was 3, now it is a 1, 13, because it has a relation with the initial state. So it is even, it was 4, now it is a 14, because it has a relation with the state number 1. Then from the state number 2, this arrow mark, and with this arrow mark I come to know that this is the acceptor for the string symbol called as a sigma minus E minus W. From this already W is there in the first step itself, W is there, so W is a loop. This is how you can construct the finite automata which recognizes the string web and eBay. You will see some more the finite automata application. Design a finite automata that reads a string made up of letters Wanda and recognize those strings that contain word HOD as a substring. First, find out the alphabet from the string HONDA. So totally 5 input symbols are there. That means from each state you should have 5 outgoing transitions. So this is the final figure. If you see this final figure, it looks very complex. So I will show you step by step. You can easily understand. First, what you can do, draw the NFA for the substring, that is HOD. So I have drawn the substring finite automata for the substring HOD. So from initial state, you can convert this NFA state into the DFA state. So already one outgoing transition is there, so 4 more outgoing transition from the 7 is a loop. From this and this we come to know that state number 8 is the acceptor for the H, and state number 7 is the acceptor for the symbols 0, O, N, D and A. From the 8, already O is there, so I need to mark 4 more outgoing transition. So H is a loop, H is a loop, H is a loop, and NDA to to the state number 7. Hence, totally from this also 5 outgoing transitions. So from this on D is there. So remaining 4 outgoing transition H is to the this and ONA to the this. Like that, you can complete the final one from the state number 7 to state number 10. HOD has comes. So once HOD has comes, so along with this HOD, any strings comes, so it should accept, because already one HOD is there in the string. So any symbols comes, so it should accept. Now that's what for the final state, all symbols is a loop. All symbols is a loop. This is how the final figure looks. One more example you can take. King port, king and port are the two substrings. So king port string, the substring is given is a KGF. From this I come to know that the state number 8 is the acceptor for the K, and state number 7 is the acceptor for the INORTGF. That means from each state we need to mark 8 outgoing transition. So this arrow mark and this arrow mark, we come to know that this is the acceptor for the 8. If you are marking outgoing transitions on the symbol K, so it is definitely looped to the state number 8. See, you can find here K to the state number 8, 6 already there, K and G. Then for the remaining symbol, it is to the initial state. Even from the 9th also, like that. K to the this state number 8 and remaining symbol to the state number 7. So from initial state to the final state, already KGF has comes. So further after F, any symbol comes which is made up of INORTGFK. So now it is accepting. Thank you.